Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 75 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 127 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 128 and question 129. Question 128. You purchase a new Azure subscription named Subscription 1. You create a virtual machine named VM1 in Subscription 1. VM1 is not protected by Azure Backup. You need to protect VM1 by using Azure Backup. Backups must be created at 1 and stored for 30 days. What should you do? First question, location in which to store the backups. First option is a blob container. A blob container is a type of cloud storage for unstructured data. So that is not for backup purpose. A file share. File share is a Microsoft easy to use cloud file system that is not for backups or keeping backups. A recovery service vault. A recovery service vault is an entity that stores the backup and recovery points created over time. So this one is the correct answer. And a storage account. A storage account is a Microsoft cloud storage solution for data storage. So this is not for the backup. Therefore, the location for keeping the backup is a recovery service vault in Azure solutions. Question 2. Object to use to configure the protection for virtual machine. A recovery plan that is not for configuring the backup. A batch schedule is not the correct answer. Batch job is not the correct answer. Therefore, a backup policy is to configure the protection for virtual machines. Let's move to next question. Question 129. You have a recovery service vault named RSV1. RSV1 has a backup policy that retains instant snapshot for 5 days and daily backup for 14 days. RSV1 performs daily backups of virtual machine 1. VM1 hosts a static website that was updated 8 days ago. You need to recover VM1 2.8 days ago. The solution must minimize downtime. What should you do first? Option A, deallocate VM1. Deallocation of VM1 would result the downtime. Therefore, this is not the correct answer. Option C, delete VM1. That would also result the downtime, because website would go down if we delete the VM1. Option D, restore VM by using create new restore configuration option. If we restore virtual machine using the create new restore configuration option, it will create a new restore configuration for VM1. This will not restore VM1 to state it was in 8 days ago and will result in downtime for the website. Therefore, this would also not be the correct option. It would require the downtime. Option B, restore VM1 by using the replace existing restore configuration option. This option will restore VM1 to the state it was in 8 days ago, while minimizing downtime. The other options will either delete VM1 or create new restore configuration, which will not minimize downtime. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Replace existing restore configuration option.
I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.